Hi, my name is Sven Vogel. I'm coming from Germany in Leipzig. So I want to talk today about running OpenShift clusters in a CloudStack environment. So first of all, it was not easy to get it running, and we had some challenges to find out how we solved the problems that we had. So before I go this track, I want to tell something about the company. Ework in numbers. So Ework is a, I think it's the same size, mid-size company like your company. We have around 200 people and 600 customers across the EU. We was founded in 1995. We are owner lead since this time, and we have the headquarters in Leipzig, and we have project offices in Bayreuth, Berlin, Wolfsburg and Zurich. We work in Leipzig with three data centers. We have enough data centers in the city so we can spread our services about this infrastructure. And and we have a revenue of 20 million in the year. What's important for us? So we hold many of certifications. That's why we work in this main field. In these areas, we find our customers. That's in the energy sector, knowledge, mobility and healthcare sector, that's mostly customer, they have mission critical applications, they need backup, they need separated infrastructures. So when we build a CloudStack infrastructure, we build for every customer own CloudStack infrastructure, mostly. We don't share resources, we build completely on a green field. So a little overview our customers. I don't know anybody who knows the European Energy Exchange. He's also in London. That's our customer they work for, and Apex Spot and BMW and any other customers, I would say. It says enough. That's why customers come to us. We have a certified infrastructure and with all certifications about all TÜV certification and also an ISA 8 certification. So the most customers are looking on this and on the process behind that and the change process that we have. What we do in CloudStack, we are active contributors in the community. I am since 2016 in the community, and what we do is bug fixing, pull requests, and our team work also on the new CloudStack UI on Primate. Mostly when we build infrastructure, then I build them with my colleague, it's Dennis Conrad and me, and we build it, so yes. And that's, you will find us sometime on GitHub with different pull requests and issues and other things. And what was the challenges? The challenges, maybe, Andrea, do you know it? We use NetApp SolidFire before. You know this product.
Before?
No.
You're not using it anymore?
Yeah, at the moment. So you know it from your before talk, you had it. Okay. So we had different challenges. So the first one is we would use open source. We love open source. Most of the things we use in our company are open source products. So Red Hat different things like from Red Hat products in the open source branch. And so the thing was to find open source products that meet our requirements. So CloudStack was set. And after this was set, so we had some problems. So what we not want was a noisy neighborhood problem, no performance degradation, and for VMs and containers. And the problem is if you want to run CloudStack with container-based workloads, so it's not so easy to find a storage system which will suit for both scenarios, which is where you can use it for in a secure environment, where you can use it for CloudStack and you can use it for a container. And what's at the moment there, if you not run like Vido, so you have VLAN separation mostly, the most people run VLAN separation, I think. And what we also need was high performance. and snapshot functionality. So because our customers mostly have needs vary most snapshots, mostly 1 hour. Every hour they make snapshots from their machines and other things. So to solve this, that's what we, which components we use. We would use KVM. We use Open vSwitch under the hood. We use two Cumulus Linux. In the outside of our network guys, they want Cumulus Linux. We want to run OpenShift, and that's our servers. We use QCT and Fujitsu servers, mostly one unit servers, and we use NetApp and Trident. And that was important because you can run, you need to find a storage system that can create snapshots, but have no impact, that you can spread it about 3 data centers. So we have a chassis awareness that we are sure when one data center goes down, all applications are spread over 3 data centers. Then when we lost one data center, mostly we can, in any time we can use lost 2 data centers, it's possible. So then we mostly secure with NetApp. So it's possible. And the other thing is NetApp produce a plugin, it's Trident. And Trident is possible to connect the same like CloudStack can connect to NetApp systems. And that's and Trident is an open source product from NetApp, which you can connect to OpenShift clusters. And I go to the hardware and then I come to our setup. Hardware, we use normal 1 rack unit servers, 2 sockets, 786 gigabit RAM, 10 gigabit interfaces, SFP, and normally we have only 1 local NVMe or 1 SATA DOM. It's depend on which system you use. You use maybe Fujitsu or QCT. Switches, we use Edge Core. Before we want to use QCT, but it's not possible because the QCT quantum computer delivery time is very high. So at the moment we use Edge Core with a little bit older chipset, but it's okay for us. In the leaf and spine, so we have 10 and 100 gigabit switches in production.
Sorry, you use
Cumulus
Linux
on this, yes.
Never, ever, use Quanta operating system for their switches. Ever.
No.
Period.
We want
to shut down 2 data centers to upgrade switches. Shut down. There was no redundancy, nothing. Possible.
You mean the operating system from?
Operating system from Quanta.
No. We won't use the bare metal switches from them.
Yeah, okay.
That was the thing, but QCT has a long delivery time, and so we used Edge Core. Yeah, normally, no. On hardware, we use on our backend we use NetApp, NetApp H500S systems. They with chassis awareness over 3 data center locations. Here's a picture. Looks like a typical appliance today. Our cloud stack installation. Some facts for you is we use KVM. At the moment, CentOS 7. We are testing now CentOS 8. As network provider, at the moment we have Open vSwitch. So maybe later there is other SDN we can use. So we tried out to figure out Nuage, but Nuage was gone from the market. They prefer SD-WAN. And as primary storage, we use NetApp. As secondary storage, we use the active passive NFS system. As our cloud stack backend, we decided to use a MariaDB Galera cluster. So it's important that the management is there, and if it's spread over 3 data centers, and when 2 data centers goes down, we have 1 working database.
Question?
Yeah.
Do you spread the Galera cluster over the 3 data centers?
Yes.
Okay. One node each or several nodes?
Several nodes, yeah. We have a three node.
Yeah.
One node there. We have dark fiber between the data centers, so it's fast enough. And Yeah, at the moment we are very close to GitHub. Mostly we run only on master. We don't use any older version. We have our own development cycle, so we test it internally, then we build it, our programmer build new features, and then we will go directly in production. There is no great time shift between test and delivery. So what we mostly use for our customers is domains project and the LDAP integration and the heavy use of the VPC features. So what was important for us, the VPC features with private gateway, because our network guys want to use different ways, because security, to go internally over the private gateway and with ACLs and routes. And on the other way, the customers come over NAT, and there are some problems because it's gray. We have on KVM some problems with redundant router, VPC router, so it's not working correctly. So at the moment we only use one router. That's an issue, but we hope we will fix that in the future. Okay, that's our design overview. The customers come in with a public IP with a NAT of the CloudStack VPC. Mostly they come with, VRF from global, from Germany. They come from each part in Germany directly to this IP address, and then they will NAT it inside in the environment, and the internal traffic goes about the private gateway. So the OpenShift cluster, what we choose was, I don't know how many people are familiar with Kubernetes and clusters, and I don't know, but I can say what you need for OpenShift or Kubernetes cluster. You need a minimum. Normally, you can make it smaller, but for redundancy, so you use three master, three etcds, infrastructure nodes, and you need worker nodes where the virtual machine can running on, the container can running on. So how run we inside of each environment? So what we need is, or what we use is, in each environment, in each project, we have a VPC with own network and VLAN based. And we use Foreman, Catello. It's also open source product. That's what I mean with we use always open source products. It's a pendant from Red Hat Satellite for discovery in DNS and DHCP, because the VPC is not really working for us, because we use separate domains and registering automatically in a free IPaaS server with all security rules that our colleagues can SSH into the virtual machines with security compliance. And that's why we use complete the setup. Foreman will trigger the new virtual machines running the OpenShift cluster, and we'll use PXE. We use a PXE image to get them running. And you see that here. We call a CloudStack API call with PSE ISO, and then it goes to the VPC network, and Foreman then will pick up the virtual machines. They come up, give them a DNS name, give them IP address, and register them in LDAP, register them in EDM, and it's working. So that is the more complex view. That was the virtual machine. So we can, in the slide before, so we saw that the OpenShift cluster are virtual machines, but we deliver with NetApp not only the virtual machines. One feature of NetApp is so we can tag us directly in the network, so we have no routing. So we thought about Ceph and other storage things. We have criteria like free data center and snapshot, and one thing was no routing of storage traffic. The storage traffic should be high performance directly come to the OpenShift infrastructure. And what we see here is the NetApp is tagged directly in the VPC network, and is also deliver also for the virtual machines of CloudStack the network. And so over the Trident plugin, the Trident pod is starting on an OpenShift cluster, request a new volume, and it will go directly to the infrastructure from CloudStack. So we have no other things. Okay, any question to here at this point? No. So now I will come to our upcoming projects. The future we are working on at the moment, a programmer from us working on a backup provider for NetApp HCI to S3 storage system. This backup provider will, I think, so 2 months, maybe it's ready, or 1 month, and we will contribute them to the community. At the moment, we think to integrate them in the backup recovery framework, but it's more maybe not so easy. And what can we do with that? Backup restore directly from CloudStack API. The thing is, a NetApp system can directly push snapshots to S3 storage system. We use in the backend the Cloudian S3 storage system, and we can push the backups there and get them back. And we extend the recurring snapshot functionality, like for grandfather father zone schema, like what you find at the moment in CloudStack, and extend the old and the new UI. At the moment, mostly the old. And another thing is we further try to fix bugs with CloudOps, because they work also on NetApp SolidFire bugs, and in this time we found any and need to fix them. Okay, that's it. That's to me. If there are some questions, please ask me. And after that,
not about the bear.
So, if I understand it correctly, your VMs are directly connected to via network to the storage they use.
They are connectly about iSCSI provider.
Okay.
And they provide, yeah, the container are directly connected. Yeah, yeah, the container are directly connected, and CloudStack has a good integrated plug-in for SolidFire, and it was integrated from Mike Dutowski for any time, and will be supported from CloudOps at the moment. And that's the way we use. Container directly, and the other over the plugin.
Give two ways.
The
plugin and the directory.
Yes, but it's the same source, SolidFire storage, and we have no security issues and we have no performance issues, because you use a Ceph system. Other thing, you have to route the traffic, because the Ceph is in the backend. We evaluated them. We evaluated other storage systems, but then you have a problem. OpenShift cluster can work with Ceph, but how you get the Ceph? You need a critical application, and the customer says nobody comes into this system. And how you get this traffic rooted into this network from CloudStack? It's not so easy. So, and the best way was the integration for about Trident and directly tagging into the VLAN. That's the way.
Yeah, with shared networks you could do this, but then you have the issue that the different containers connect all to the same backend.
Yeah.
So yeah, you could. Yeah, it's difficult without the routine.
It's really difficult, because each customer has his own OpenShift cluster. At the moment, we're running around 70 OpenShift clusters with.
And they have full access.
They have full access on the UI, because OpenShift is a good cloud UI, and they have full access on the application.
But that's
not secure enough. So they want the complete. They check the complete stack, and it's not secure, then it's not possible. It's the same like our customers want own racks and the other.
At the end, just playing around. At the end, if you have a shared network and you have a Ceph cluster, you only need a direct connection to the monitors, and then you could split via the crash map your Ceph cluster and use different users or different hosts, and then you only have the connection to this. But in the back end, you have a big cluster, but you can see this on this host.
Yeah.
You could maybe do it.
Yeah,
but yeah, it's complex.
It's complex, and they we thought about a Quagga and a routing like this. Maybe there is a talk on the other side. There was today about routing Ceph storage or something like that. But if you have a customer, they check all systems, all layers from your from the network. The network must be separated. And each layer must be separated, and that's the point where it's complicated. Yeah.
So we're still on solid fire as well, right? You're still using solid fire.
Yes. It's okay. We had some any bugs that we fixed with CloudOps, and we found curious bugs like virtual machines. Each startup of more we have around 400 virtual machines on this cluster, and mostly virtual machines like 20 gigabyte RAM up. And the thing was, if we deploy, every time we deploy more virtual machines, it will be slower. So at least we wait 10 minutes to start a virtual machine. So we found for SolidFire, I found curious bugs, and we fixed them. If we could track them down, and other curious things, and that's why we're at the moment on this track. Yeah.
Any more questions? Great. Thank you, Sven.
Thank you.